In this video, we're gonna get familiar with BCC Plus Light Flicker, available as a standalone filter, as well as inside of Continuum FCP for Final Cut Pro customers. Let's hop inside of my timeline and see what this effect is all about. So I'm here inside of Final Cut, and I'm gonna head to the BCC Film Style category, where regardless if you have Continuum FCP or the standalone Flicker, this is where you're gonna find Light Flicker. So I'll just apply it to the clip in my timeline. And right away, if I go to the beginning and do a full screen playback, we can see a flicker happening, transitioning between light and dark flicker. I'll escape out of there. And the one thing that we wanna use to control the flicker is the speed and the amount. So if I set this to a low speed here in Final Cut and a higher amount, let's go with 60, we're gonna see more of a pulsating effect. I'll escape out of here. And this time what I'm gonna do is change the speed amount to be much higher to a maximum value of 100 and then a low flicker amount of 8. And we're gonna see more of a faster flicker light effect. Now to really zoom in onto what this light flicker is doing, let's head inside of the effects editor and actually turn something on called curve view. To do that, at the top of the light flicker effect, I'm gonna click on the effects editor badge. And with all BCC effects, we've got presets here on the left-hand side that we can choose from. I wanna be able to get a better sense of what's going on from the changes I made inside of Final Cut. So I'm gonna head over to the parameters here on the right-hand side and change my curve view from off to render over effect. So this squiggly curve that you see here, anything that's over the line happens to be a brighter flicker, and anything underneath the line happens to be a darker flicker. This is because the flicker style is currently set to bright and dark. If you wanted to, we could easily switch this to have a brightened flicker only, and then all of the spikes of the curve are going to be above the line, or alternatively, we could choose darken only. In this case, I'll go back to the default of bright and dark. The other thing we can notice here with the curve is that currently the light flicker is smooth. Instead, if we wanted something a bit more harsh, we could choose spiky. I'll just play back so that we can see this here inside of the effects editor. So to see the impact of speed and amount, let me go back to set a higher amount value. You can see how much these curves grow in both bright and dark. And just set this to a lower speed like we had before. I'll make this 20. And we'll notice the intervals change over time. Right now, the time view is set to full effect, but we could do different time durations. So right now, the time view is currently only representing 5 seconds of time on the clip. I'll set that back to full effect. So using this curve effect will allow us to dial in those speed and amount values a little bit more, not to mention see what happens when we introduce noise. So if I go to the noise value and add some random noise, just notice how much more chaotic this curve gets between bright and dark values. Once again, I'll introduce a faster speed, set this to 80. Since this amount is so high, I'll just have a lower amount of a value set to 8. So we've still got that noise introducing randomness across our flicker, but we have a high speed, low amount flicker producing the following result. Excellent. Another thing we could do is introduce a random seed so that we have a different random flicker produced from the noise. We've also got these random values, so we could add some flicker randomness, some intensity randomness if desired. Now, one additional cool thing about Flicker is that there's also some built-in effects, such as prism and doing some color correction. So for instance, if I click the disclosure triangle next to prism, I can enable this to get some chromatic aberration here in my shot. Let's take a look at this with the curve view turned off. And I'm just gonna apply this effect to bring it back to the host. And we'll see that these effects that we made carry on over into Final Cut. If I click the disclosure triangle next to prism, I can play with that amount to make it greater or a lot more subtle. The other thing that we can introduce is a full-on color correction to our clip and the flicker by enabling this. So we play with things such as saturation or hue to give our clip a different look. I'll press Command-Z to undo those. Let's play back and see what we have so far on this clip. So I'll go to the beginning and we'll see our flicker result. So one thing you might have noticed is that flicker affects the entire image. It's not just limited to the bright sources, like visible lights in the scene. If we wanted something like that, we could actually use the built-in pixel chooser to limit it to bright values or of values of a specific color. So to see this, I'm going to apply it to the clip in this new timeline. And we've got that base flicker applied to the overall image. And we'd just like to limit it to these hanging lights that we see here. So for this, I'm going to head to pixel chooser and we're going to turn it on. So you might be used to some of the pixel chooser properties if you've ever played around with Mocha inside of Final Cut Pro. When you click that Mocha mask button and then create a mask and track it, when you bring it back over to Final Cut, pixel chooser is automatically on where you can refine that mask. This time we're going to use pixel chooser for something different. In fact, there is a matte section here at the bottom of the effect. And right now we're going to choose a channel to work with. Let's go with Luma. And to see what's just happened, I'm going to click the View Matte Mask button. White values represent where it's going to flicker. Gray is sort of in between. And black is where flicker is not going to show. If we head down to refining the matte, we can do a few different things. One is I can actually switch this from levels to threshold and then drag this threshold amount to then choose just the bright pixels in the shot. So you can see I could try to refine it to just the lights over top. Alternatively, I'll go back to levels where we get a black and white slider that we can use. If I increase the black level, notice the limitation to pretty much just the lamps overhead, and then play with the white level just to increase the surrounding area, this is what's going to flicker. Now we can pre-smooth this amount too, so that it feathers off nicely, and make additional changes to our matte by blurring and choking it if required. I'll go to the top of the effect and just click off the View Matte Mask, close out the pixel chooser properties. So I'm going to leave the amount as is, but I'm going to increase the speed. And for this, because I want a fast flicker, introduce quite a bit of noise and a random seed. Let's go to the beginning of the clip and play this back full frame so we could see the flicker of the lights occurring. Now again, this is actually rotating between bright and dark values, and I just want to have it flicker to brighter values and change the flicker style to be brighten only. Let's play that back from here. Now we have that nice constant flicker with our lights. Now, if we wanted to just have it flicker temporarily, keep in mind all of these values are keyframeable, and we can even use this as a transitional element in certain cases. Okay, let's see what's going on in this timeline. I'll go to the beginning and play this back.
Let the ceremonies begin.
Okay, and you might have noticed a flicker at the very end there reacting to the sound of the announcer. Now this was done using Beat Reactor. If I select this clip, we'll notice that BCC Plus Light Flicker has been applied. And if I twirl down the Beat Reactor options, it's been enabled. When you enable Beat Reactor, you can then go and select some audio somewhere on your system. So just keep in mind, I rendered out a tiny bit of audio from my Final Cut Pro timeline and then had Beat Reactor select that from my desktop. Once the audio is selected, one thing to note is that Beat Reactor comes with a graph. So we can see that graph here. And I've enabled one audio parameter called speed to affect the speed of the light flicker based on some of the frequencies in the announcer's voice, which happen to be around the green range. If I skim this clip, I can see the portions of the graph that I've selected and the output here on this gray bar on the right-hand side. And choosing, if I open up my audio apply options A, I can see here that I've set a lower output minimum and maximum so that it didn't flicker so greatly. And this allowed for the result of the flicker to happen when the announcer speaks.
Let the ceremonies begin.
This can open up all types of options with music, with dialogue, as well as sound effects. And this is just scratching the surface of what light flicker can do. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and check us out at borisfx.com.